It's the final homestand of the year for Minnesota and an early evening matchup against the Colorado Avalanche at the Xcel Energy Center. Parisi behind the net, deflects to Staal. Staal from a sharp angle, backs away, plays to the line. Scandella shot, that got through, save, rebound Niederreiter. And Pickard was able to slide across and get a piece of it. Hominville after it. First man there is Lindholm. Hominville intercepts, goes across to Scandella for a shot and a save by Pickard. He came out to challenge the Minnesota defenseman. Blake Como plays it ahead at center for Colorado, but the Wild quickly back on the attack. Hominville to Coyle. Coyle for Hansley, scores!
When you got guys that are 8 to 10 feet apart, it's easy to make little passes. They don't have to be perfect. Great puck support all the way down and towards the net. Hansel has an easy chip in there. Hansel trying to figure out and find ways that he can contribute for the Wild.
Here's another chance for Minnesota, but Pickard's able to cover the puck as Haller races through the offensive zone for Minnesota.
It's been so great with Zucker all season long.
Haller replaces Koivu on the dot, wins the faceoff. A long shot, kicked in, they score! Spurgeon took the initial shot, goes in off the skate of Haller, and it's 2-0 Minnesota.
It went over his foot or by his foot, so he didn't even touch it. They support each other with some offensive plays.
Comfort in for Colorado, and they score. Landeskog beats Dubnyk.
Devin Dubnyk was a little bit deep right here, and so when he pushes across, he has no momentum. All he has is the strength of the push.
Sidesteps Rantanen, crosses center and dumps it in. Koivu intercepts along the half wall, centered for Granlund to Holly, scores!
Kind of nifty little feet there in between three bodies for the Avalanche, and Holland just comes across and makes himself available.
On the points, Hominville wins the draw. Brodin has it along the boards, plays to the corner, ball to Parisi, scores! 6 seconds into the power play, it's 4-1 Minnesota.
Look at this, two guys go behind the net, and Zach Parisi says, that's the kind of shot that I could take.
Jeremy Smith on in relief of Calvin Pickard.
Sometimes it's what you keep that really makes a difference.
Dumba has a deflected shot, saved by Smith. He has no idea where it is.
The redirect hit him in the pad and then just sat there.
Spurgeon in the middle, gives it to Granlund. Granlund down low for Koivu. Across for Suter, but he hit the side of the net. And now Charlie Coyle carries ahead. Coyle into the Colorado zone, centered, Haller shot, save Smith, and then he stopped him on a backhander on the rebound. Schrader back to the line, Suter looking for a lane, floats a wrist shot in that Smith knocks away. Suter recovers, plays it across, a quick shot, they score! Schrader beats Smith over the glove side, and it's 5-1 Minnesota. Zone held momentarily. Now Andraghetto ahead for Rantanen. Rantanen scores! And just like that, the Avs have an answer, and it's 5-2. Stewart deflects it across off the skate of Johnson. Schrader ducks underneath and fires wide. Barry tied up by Coyle. Hansel's out front. His backhander goes wide. All the scoring coming in the first two periods here tonight. Wild in front, 5-2. Centering pass, and Duchesne is denied by a sprawling Dubnyk.
What a beauty that was.
Duchesne had a lot of room, and Dubnyk diving across, glove first, to deflect it over the top of the goal. Back to play it to the Avs. Good stick by Staal, knocked it away. Parisi centers, Coyle off the post. Suter plays it ahead. Coyle tied up by Nieto. Hominville to Coyle. Coyle fires, saved by Smith. Here in St. Paul, in the Wild, back in the win column and back to the century mark for the third time in franchise history with a 5-2 win. Devin Dubnyk, after a slight break, is back And he's back in the win column. A new Wild record, his 38th victory of the season. And
finally, he gets over that hump, gets a W. The Wild able to shake some monkeys off their back. And they'll face Carolina in their final home regular season game on Tuesday.